We've seen that the normal variation in carbon dioxide is associated with ice ages in North America over the last few hundred thousand years. But what lessons can we take from an even longer time span? Have there been large-scale changes in CO2 even greater than seen in the last million years? And have they altered the climate? If we look at the very, very long term, there was an extraordinary period of time that's now referred to as Snowball Earth. This occurred between 700 and 600 million years ago, before the evolution of large land-living animals. And the whole Earth was frozen because CO2 had been taken out of the atmosphere so effectively by microorganisms during the formation of petroleum. Fossil fuels are of two major types. The first one is petroleum, where we get oil and gas. And this is from marine sediments of the phytoplankton that lives in great abundance in the oceans. And as the phytoplankton die, they settle in the bottom of the sea, and they form a sort of sludge of organic material. Through time, this organic material is covered by sand. It gets compressed. And if we look at it deeper in the layers beneath the surface, there are trapped oil deposits. There's gas. And this has taken a billion years to build up. But as this built up, this led to a great loss in CO2. A blanket was now missing from the Earth's surface. Heat could radiate out, and the Earth got very, very cold. So as photosynthesis gradually converted atmospheric carbon dioxide to petroleum, removing a major greenhouse gas, there was widespread glaciation. In fact, the whole Earth was covered with snow. It's estimated that across the surface of the Earth, there was an ice cap of various thickness that was really quite striking. This is now in the southern hemisphere, where most of the continents were at that time. And there was ice caps that were nearly 5 kilometers deep. The temperature was quite cool. There were only a few places around the equator that ever got above freezing. The rest was snowy. During this global ice age, glaciers formed on the entire surface of the Earth, grinding rocks and carrying nutrients down into the sea. We saw that the Earth's atmosphere varied enormously beginning about 2.2 billion years ago with the evolution of the cyanobacteria. This is when photosynthesis first appeared on Earth. The algae were able to convert CO2 into oxygen, and so oxygen level, which is up here, rose quite substantially. This stayed at a certain stable level in the atmosphere for a billion years until Snowball Earth. With Snowball Earth, where we now have an enormous amount of phosphorus, one of those key elements in life, being ground out of the rocks and into the oceans, there were nutrients that were enabling a lot of life to be active in the oceans. Another new burst of oxygen came into the air. And in fact, this, and we mentioned this earlier, was when the multicellular organisms were first able to evolve, because there was enough oxygen for the first time to support a large heterotrophic organism. So the rise in phosphorus caused by the grinding of the glaciers and that global ice age increased algal abundance, which raised oxygen, and that ultimately led to the evolution of multicellular organisms. So the signature of Snowball Earth has been really quite profound. There was then a long period of time where the Earth warmed up again, and this was stable now until about 360 to 300 million years ago, when once again there was a vast transfer of carbon dioxide out of the air into the Earth when coal first was formed. What is coal? Well, coal is unlike oil. Oil is from marine sediments of microorganisms, but coal is compressed plant material. Seed-bearing plants that grew in swamps and terrestrial forests, these first appeared on the surface of the Earth about 360 million years ago. And when the plants evolved, they had woody structures made out of material that could not be easily digested and eaten by organisms. And so the dead material would accumulate in the form of peat, again getting buried underneath rock formations, forming lignite and ultimately coal. So this is during the Carboniferous Age, 360 to 300 million years ago. The Earth was covered by all these woody plants for the first time. They're now taking carbon dioxide out of the air, and this is now deposited in the form of plant material. The evolution of plant material, lignin and bark and cellulose and wood, let the trees grow tall, but there was nothing that could eat it. So this material is now lying there and is not in that part of that circulation between the atmosphere and the Earth's surface anymore. This also led to yet another boost in the amount of oxygen in the air. And then oxygen, which up until that point had been maybe 15-20% of the air, is now 35%, the highest it's ever been in Earth's history. And with 35% of oxygen, you could breathe through your skin if you're an amphibian. Remember the frogs and salamanders, they couldn't get very far away from water because they had to breathe through their skin. They don't have very good lungs. But there was so much oxygen in the atmosphere during the Carboniferous Age that they could grow to be 6 meters long, a 20-foot long salamander, breathing through its skin. But all of this photosynthesis, all of this formation of wood for the first time, all of this then ultimately being converted into coal, and we have coal deposits through vast areas of Australia, Siberia, North America, taking all that carbon out of the air, reduce carbon dioxide from the air, and we had another ice age. Without that blanket of carbon dioxide, the Earth once again got really, really cold, and the Karoo ice age lasted for nearly 60 million years. So the negative of what we're seeing now would be the loss of CO2. With the advent of microorganisms for the first time pulling carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere, forming petroleum, and then later with the advent of the plants pulling carbon dioxide out in the form of tree bark and tree branches, wood, CO2 is leached out of the air, we lose the layer of blanket, and ice ages cover the Earth for millions of years.